Ik ben Hans Lambeau, hoofdredacteur Database Magazine. En voor dit interview op BI-platform is onze gast Barry Devlin. Barry werkte jarenlang voor IBM, in het begin op het gebied van data warehousing. En later ging hij zich bezighouden met SOA en Web 2.0 technologie. Sinds begin 2008 is hij onafhankelijk consultant en analist. Barry, thanks for being our guest today.
Welcome.
One of your topics is how could a company go into the next phase of BI if they don't even know what went wrong in the former phase? Do you know the answer to that question?
Well, as a consultant, I do claim to know all of the answers. But in terms of your particular question, the idea that I would be saying is that lots of things did go right with the first phase of BI, and we need to build on that. But what particularly was missing from the first phase of business intelligence was the ability to step outside of logical, rational thinking and go beyond that into what we would call right brain thinking.
What do you mean by that?
Well, what I mean by that is if you think of the left brain as the masculine way of thinking, it is about cause and effect, it's about logic, it's about, you know, if that happened, then this is likely to happen, and probabilities and all of those sort of things. The right brain, the right side of the brain, which is often called the feminine side of the brain, is actually much more about associations and about bringing different thoughts together. And sometimes we need to do something, especially as men, to bring our brains into a different way of thinking. So looking beyond, and let's take some of the simple ones, mind mapping, brain games, and indeed all sorts of symbolic thinking cause us to look at things in a slightly different way. What that brings is creativity, it brings innovation, it brings a new way of thinking. Now, of course, what you need to do is you need to then combine that with the logic. So first of all, you step into the right brain in order to get new ideas, then you move back into the left brain in order to understand the consequences and to bring that together. So the first point I would say to you in terms of old BI versus new BI, and I think of that as business intelligence versus business insight, the first point is we need to re-emphasize or recreate our connection with symbolic or intuitive thinking. And that's something that we actually probably will have to consciously do because we're so used to, in terms of our training and in terms of our upbringing, to really think, you know, as if the world is totally logical.
But do we really need a new way of thinking to go into the next phase of BI?
Yeah, I do believe that we do need a new way of thinking. That's part of it. I said that's only one part of it. I'm not suggesting that's the only thing we need, but we do need to really re-energize a different part of our brain. The other part of it, I think, probably is more short-term, more useful for people to grasp immediately. And that's the fact that one of the ways that people get into the creative mode, become more innovative, is to actually work together as groups. So when I go and sit in my office on my own, I'm unlikely to have a new idea, right? I keep repeating the same old stuff. But if I actually get a group of people around who have different thoughts, who have different ideas, then I may actually be able to pick and choose and synthesize something new. So collaborative working is a very important part of the new BI, because what it does is it enables people to get together and to work innovatively in a new way. These days, of course, the world is not all about sitting in the one room. So we need to do collaboration across the web, across the network. So moving into collaborative computing, creating the ability to have a process which works together, you know, around the world and over the entire thinking process, that becomes a very key part of the next stage of business insight. And probably that's probably easier for us left brain guys to understand than the other stuff.
You're talking about working together. Who should work together?
In terms of business intelligence, the people that need to work together are, of course, the decision makers. You know, in the past, and let's call it BI 1.0 if you like, in the past, the people who were working on business intelligence were typically business analysts, and they have a certain way of thinking. They're trained to in a certain method, certain ways of thought. Now, we need actually to move some of our thinking beyond the business analysts and begin to really engage the people who make the decisions. And they're going to be different people depending on the decisions. So when we talk about, let's say, operational BI, the people who are making the decisions are the people in the front offices. They're the people in the call centers. These people are going to be making decisions that they've never had to make in the past. If we're talking about the boardroom, of course, we're talking about the executives, we're talking about the managers, the senior people in the company. And we really do want to engage those people and get them part of the real process. Old business intelligence really just thought about, let me measure the stuff and let me evaluate it. And then it stopped and it just handed the stuff over and said, okay, I'm out of here, let's go and do something different. But new business intelligence has to go beyond that. We measure, then we evaluate, and then we move into the next phase, which is to decide and then to act. And that's a cycle. And when we've acted, we need to come back and remeasure what it was that we've done so that we know, hey, did we actually succeed? Were our objectives met? And there's two breaks in that cycle today. The first break is when you come to the end of the business intelligence tool as it exists today, you sort of stop and you say, okay, there are all the facts, now go away and make a decision. That's one break. We've got to close that gap. And the second gap is when the action has been taken. Most times, companies never go back and look at the outcome and say, well, I made that decision and that's the result. Did they actually match? Did I get what I expected? So that's the two places where I think we make a difference.
To me, it's hard to understand, Barry, how a social network could be involved in business intelligence.
Well, I think the answer to that is that business intelligence so far has typically been about individuals analyzing data, massaging data, and coming up with some thoughts about how to move forward. But beyond the single person working on their own, what most people will tell you is that when you bring together a group of people, you get more insightful decisions, you get more knowledge brought into the process, you get more a bigger variety of views. Now, having this wider variety of views then typically does tend to lead to better decisions and more insightful decisions. Going forward, of course, we're not going to have people physically sitting around the table all the time. We're moving increasingly into a virtual world with, you know, businesses spread out. We need to create an environment within which this social networking, if you like, spreads out onto the internet. The ability to have a meeting that doesn't all take place in one room. When you're face-to-face with somebody, as I am with you, Hans, I mean, we speak a lot with our bodies. There's a lot of trust that's being built simply by the way we talk to one another. When you work on the internet, it's different. When you're working with text or emails or even instant messaging, as you can see by some of the things that have gone wrong in that environment, people either don't have trust or they trust people beyond what they should. So social software, social networking software, is a way of creating that environment in which trust can grow. It's a very subtle business, and it really involves creating, providing the set of tools that enable people to talk to one another in a free way and to create some of the underlying confidence that people can have in one another. Now, bringing that into business intelligence, what that does is it enables us to give people the ability to, first of all, form a team over large networks, different locations, different time zones. That brings in new thoughts, new ideas, and then we can apply a process to that, which then enables you to start taking out different pieces of that and making decisions about it. So it's a question really, Ants, of bringing in new ideas and bringing them in a structured way. And that basically is how I think we move from business intelligence, which was very typically a left brain thing, to business insight, which I see as engaging both sides of the brain equally. Intelligence on the left side and insight or intuition on the right side. So those two things, the male and the female, if you like, are key parts of our personalities and of our culture, and that we need to bring forward into the decision-making process.
Wilt u meer weten over Barry Devlin en zijn filosofie, zijn theorie? Kijkt u dan op zijn eigen channel op BI Network.